morning children, I welcome you to my class. Today we are going to do the exercises of lesson 11. But before starting that, I want to tell you that many are questioning that after lesson I am teaching lesson 11 because this is in your syllabus. Actually lesson 1, lesson 11 and lesson 12 you are going to learn for your first unit. So please follow whatever is being taught in the class. You just follow that, which lessons we are teaching you just follow. Okay, let us start the exercise. First one is fill in the blanks, okay? I shall write the answers. You may copy the whole thing in your notebooks. Machines are of two types. Number one. Machines are of two types. Number one is simple and complex, okay? Number two. A machine acts by reducing the force needed to displace an object. Force. Number three. Lever is a rigid bar or rod that rests on a support called fulcrum or pivot. I taught you, you will write fulcrum only because it is given in the book. It will be better for you. Fulcrum. In class 1 levers, the fulcrum is in between the effort and the load. In class 1 levers, okay? Bottle openers, nutcrackers and wheelbarrows are examples of class 2 levers. There are two main type of pulleys, fixed pulley and movable pulley. Fixed pulley. Pulley and movable pulley. Okay. Now please see, in my book I have question number 7 also. I don't think you have in your book or not, but still I am writing. Some common examples of wedges are axes, knives and our teeth. Some common examples of wedges. Okay. So children, please copy down in your copies all these things. Number B. Now we are going to do exercise B. That is, write true and false statements. But if the statement is false, we are going to correct it. Okay, you should know the correct statement. Okay, number one. The longer the rod of the lever, the harder it is to move the load. It is false. So number one you write down. False. Now you correct the statement. Here. False. Here will write down. The longer the rod of the lever, the easier it is to move, the load. See children, we are changing here. It was harder, we have changed into easier. Next number you please see. Number 2, in class 1 levers, the load is in between the effort and the fulcrum. It is also false. It is also false. It will be in class 1 levers. In class 1 levers, the fulcrum. We are changing here. The fulcrum is in between. We are changing. The fulcrum is in between the effort and the load. The effort and the load. We are changing here also, okay? Please see once again. Number 1 also please see, it is false. The longer the liver, the easier it is to move the load. And number two, it is also a false statement. We are correcting, we are making the statement correct. In class 1 livers, the fulcrum is in between the effort and the load. Number three, in class 3 livers, the effort is in between the fulcrum and the load. This is true. What is the effort? The effort is between the fulcrum and the load. Number 4, you see. Pulley is a simple machine made up of a slanting surface which connects a lower level to a higher level. That is false. It is not a pulley. It will be an inclined plane. Now number 5, using screws, two things can be interlocked. Yeah, this is true. Number 5, it will be true. Okay. Next one. Now we are going to do exercise C, that is match the following. Now we are going to do straight matching. Please see here, class 1 liver, scissors. Here we are adding the examples, okay. Class 2 liver, nutcracker. Pulley, it will be crane. Wedge, it will be knife. Inclined plane, it will be ram. Okay, next one, D. Children, now we are going to do exercise D, that is tick the correct answer. Number 1, you see here, which of these simple machines helps to move heavy objects to a height? All of you know, it is inclined plane. Tongs are an example of third class liver, okay, third class liver you see here. Liver is a rigid bar or rod that rests on a support called fulcrum, you all know. And number 4, which of this is a modified liver of the first class? Now this is not given in your book, but you should know why. The answer is wheel and axle is a modified liver of the first class because it rotates in a circle around the center point or fulcrum. Now you see, where is the fulcrum in first class liver? It is in the center. So this one is the example. Wheel and axle is an example of a modified liver of the first class. Okay. So children, please copy exercise A, B, C, D in your science copies and revise. Thank you.